Hello everyone, this is Kenny Bruni from Cambrotech and welcome back to the channel. So in this series of videos, we are going to learn Bootstrap and we are going to learn Bootstrap version 5. So at the time of recording this video, this is about the latest version of Bootstrap. And this time around, we are going to learn Bootstrap in a different way. And this is what I mean. We are going to build this beautiful interface at the end of the day after going through this series. So first of all, we are going to learn the basic syntax or the classes some of the classes, and I believe once we build this project or this website, we are going to get our hands into the nitty-gritty of everything with Bootstrap. I think the only thing that's not Bootstrap related is this Google map I have over here. But as far as the design is concerned, there's no single line of CSS. Everything you see over here is with Bootstrap, and I believe this is a very good project to get you going at the end of this series. Again, this website, as you see over here, is responsive. So I'll click on this and click on inspect. So this is going to be one of the mobile views of the website. So on an iPhone X, this is how the website is going to appear. And as you can see, it is looking very cool as you have it over here. So we are going to learn the breakpoints and apply them accordingly. Then we can also preview how the website is going to look on an iPad. So on an iPad or on a tablet of this screen size, this is how this website is going to look. And it looks very cool. Then finally, let's look at, let's say, an Android phone like the Galaxy S5. So on a Galaxy S5, this is how it's going to look like. And I think this is going to be something very interesting. So if you're excited, just as I am, first of all, we are going to learn the very basic syntax and we are going to go into Bootstrap proper, how we organize our websites and stuff like that. So if you are interested in this particular project and more of this, kindly give a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. So this is a Bootstrap official website. I'll leave the link in the description below, and that's getbootstrap.com. Now, on this landing page, there are bits of information we can read over here, and we have information on installation, JS deliver, we have Bootstrap icons, and we are going to cover a number of these things as we move along. But for now, let's click on all releases. So on all releases, we seem to have all the versions of Bootstrap over here. And as you can see, it started some years back from version 1, and now we are about the latest version. And from version to version, you could see that there are some improvements within the classes and components that we can have access to. So over here, we are going to use the latest version, or we are going to learn the latest version. That's version 5.1. So I'll click on this link, and here we are. So first of all, I'm going to introduce you to the two methods, or the two main methods, that we can have access to Bootstrap. And we can either download the files and use them, or we can use the CDN. So first of all, I'm going to show you how to download the files. So here we have a download link over here. I'll click on this link. So on this download page, now bear in mind, you can see that we have getbootstrap.com/docs/5.1. So this 5.1 /getting-started/download, this 5.1 actually shows the version we are working with. So when we come down, there are a number of things we can download. You can see that we have the compiled CSS and JS, that's the JavaScript. And all that we need to do here is we need to click on this. So this is a compiled minified version of everything that we will need. So I'll click on this download button, and this will take about some few minutes. All right, so the download is complete, and let's go to my desktop, where I have the zip file over here. So we then need to unzip this. So I'll just double click on this, and I'll extract to my desktop. Okay, so this is what we can actually delete this. So into it, we have a CSS folder, then also a JavaScript folder. Now, there are a number of things over here, and they may look intimidating at the first glance, but we only need two things over here, one in this folder and the other in the other folder. So basically what we need is the CSS, the minified version of the CSS, and it's exactly this that we need. Okay, so the bootstrap.min, and as you can see, the file type over here is CSS file. Now bear in mind, you also have this bootstrap.min.css, but the file type is not the CSS, so we don't actually need this. So we need this, so I'll just copy this, Control C, and let me open up VS Code over here, and let's create a folder. So over here, I'll click on this, and inside of my desktop, let me just create a new folder, and I'll call this Bootstrap. So I have this Bootstrap folder created, and all that I want is, I'd want to have an index.html file. Then the next thing I need is, I'll need a style.css. Okay, so let me hide this and come back here. Remember, I copied this, so I'll do a Control C, and I'll come in here and come and paste this over here. Then the next thing I'll need is, I need to come back into this file and go to the JS. So with the JavaScript file, this is what I need. I need a bootstrap.bundle.min, and this is the JavaScript file. So I'll copy this one, I'll do a Control C and bring it here. All right, so now inside of my VS Code, I have this JavaScript file and the CSS over here. Now all that I want to do is, I can put up the starter templates. So I'll do the exclamation mark over here, and I'll press enter for this auto-generated HTML starter template to show up. And let me just change the title to home and save. Now I have an extension, so clearly I'm using the prettier extension, so it formats everything I have in here. So don't be too worried when you see some of the things changing up. So what I'm going to do is, first of all, I'm going to show you why we need Bootstrap. So remember, I have this style.css. This is my own styling CSS that I want to include over here. And all that I need to do is, I want to put up a link tag, and I'm going to link it up with the style.css. All right. Then I just want to have, let's say, an H1. And I'll type in Cambrotech. So I'll save this. And I also have an extension, live server, and I'm going to open this up in live server. So here we have Cambrotech showing up over here. Now, as far as what you've done is concerned, we haven't done anything Bootstrap yet, but let me show you this. I can come into my style.css. Remember, I already have it linked up on line 8 over here. I can come into style.css and decide to style some few things over here. So let's say I want to style this Cambrotech. This Cambrotech is in an H1 tag. So there are a couple of ways I can do this. I can select the H1 tag and do the styling. And this is what I mean. I can do an H1. And let's say I want to apply a color. And let's say I want to do red. So color red. Now when I come back here, we can see that our text has now changed from the default black color to red. All right. Now, this is one way of styling it. Now, the other way of styling this, and once we come back here, everything is gone. Now, the other way of styling this is to come in here and give the H1 here a class. So let's say I'll call this my-color. So I'll save this. This is my-color. And once I come here, nothing has changed. So what we can do here is, we can come into the style.css and come and grab my-color. Because there's a class, we use the dots to select it. And now I can do color. And this time around, let's do blue. So when I save this and I come back here, now we see that the color has changed to blue. The difference between what we did previously and what we are doing now is, this time around, we are using classes. And it has its own advantage, because if we are to have another H1 tag, and let's say we have learn programming, and we save, clearly learn programming is not going to have the blue color applied to it. But if the styling, and once again, let me clear this, and if we are to do H1 and say color red, now because we are targeting the H1s, all the H1s will have that styling, and that's why sometimes we need to apply the classes in here so that they'll be specific to a particular HTML element. So this is one way of doing it. Now there's also the other way, so let me come back here and do a Control Z so that I'll get back to my color blue over here. So here we have color blue. Now we can also apply an ID over here, so I can do ID, and let's say I'll call this my second color. I'll do my second color like this. So this is the name of the ID, and in the case of an ID, we use the hash to select it. So I'll do my second color, and this time around let me give it a background. So I'll give it a background of yellow. All right. So when I save this, you're going to see that this is going to have a background of yellow. So this is what traditionally we are quite used to as far as styling our websites are concerned. Now what Bootstrap does is Bootstrap gives us a bunch of classes which we can easily have access to and use them. And that's exactly why we have this downloaded over here. So what I'm going to do is, I am going to come into my index.html and I'm going to link the CSS file I have over here. That's the Bootstrap, the one we just brought in here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to bring out the link tag, and inside of the href, I'm going to link up the bootstrap.main.css. Now when I save it, and now when I come here, you can see that automatically the font is changing over here. Good. Now, in order to see things very clearly, let me come in here and bring in another H1 tag. And let's say I have, you can do it, as the text in here. So far, so good. We have this default black color over here. Now, we can just come in here and apply a Bootstrap class. And for starters, let's say we have a txt dash primary. Now when I save this, we have this color changed to blue, and that's exactly why we need CSS. So instead of coming into style.css to come and code or write CSS code over here, Bootstrap is giving us some classes that we can use. Those are pre-built that we can use. Yes, of course, we can customize them. But trust me, just knowing the default colors and the default classes will even make your life very easier as far as programming is concerned. And that's exactly what you are going to concentrate on. All right, so in this session, what we've done so far is I wanted to explain exactly why we needed Bootstrap, because Bootstrap is a library. So all these CSS or any other CSS in terms of styling has some kind of classes that has already been designed for us. So we just have to apply the classes. We need not to come in here and come and write any CSS for that matter. So when I click on this bootstrap.main.css, this is it. And we need not to change anything over here. So there are a bunch of styling over here that are very interesting, and you are going to see them as we move along. So this is it. And once, of course, we have, then we also have the JavaScript, because there are some other aspects of Bootstrap that requires us to have the JavaScript. For instance, if you are using the tooltip and modal components, we need this JavaScript in here. And clearly, in order to do that, I'll just have to come and write in a script tag over here and give it a source. So the source is going to link up to this bootstrap.bundle.main.js, and this is exactly what we need for our Bootstrap.
So this is just one way of doing it. This is we using the downloaded Bootstrap, and we can have this and go on and on and on. Now, most of the time, what I usually do as far as using Bootstrap is I normally use the CDN. So let me come back here to introduction. And inside of this, we have what we call the CDN. So the CDN is a content delivery network. And basically what you have over here is you have your, you don't need to download Bootstrap in the first place. All that you need to do is to come into the starter template and come and copy this starter template. Now I'm going to clear everything I have over here and I'm going to paste what I just copied. So I'll save this. And if I come back here, you can see that I only have Hello World. Now look over here. What I have here is, you can see that I have the Bootstrap CSS, and the Bootstrap CSS is linking me to, look at this link. It is a CDN jsdelivery.net.npm, and I have Bootstrap at 5.1.3 distribution CSS, and here we have the bootstrap.me.css, and that's exactly what we downloaded. This is what we downloaded and we included it manually, but this time around it's being hosted on some server somewhere, so we are just linking it up. All right, now you can see that you also have the JavaScript file over here, or the link over here, and over here it says we have two options over here. So the option one is we can link this one bundle with Popper, and we are going to see exactly what Popper does. So this is the cdn.jsdeliver.net/npm/bootstrap@5.1.3/distribution/js, and this is exactly what we had over here. So we had the bootstrap.bundle.main.css, and that's exactly what we linked up over here. So this is the first option. Now the second option is we want to separate the Popper and the Bootstrap JS, and that's basically just using either of these two. All right, so what I'm going to do is I'm just going to maintain this Hello World, and just as we wrote a class over here, remember we did something like tst-primary. Now when I save this and come back here, we have this primary color showing up over here, and we didn't have to include any downloaded CSS over here. So moving forward, we are just going to use the CDN, and all that we need is, now we need to learn the Bootstrap classes and how to apply them. And that's exactly what you are going to do in the next video.